Hey kids, welcome to Dude Night. My name is Clark and I'm your host today on a new show we like to call Border Patrol, where we celebrate the import beers that made craft brewing great. Here's a little background and why I'm doing this. In around 1880, there were over 2,200 licensed breweries in the United States of America. Then Prohibition happened, all hell broke loose, and by the early 80s, we were left with 44. Pitiful. And quite frankly, of those 44, pretty much all the beer tasted like horse piss. So, people got a little bit of coin in their pocket, started traveling around the world, went to Europe, Australia, places like that, had a little bit of beer, realized what beer was really supposed to taste like. They came back, had that yearning for it, and the import beer market just exploded. So, craft brewers decided, homebrewers decided that they'd had enough. They were going to make beer that tasted just like that or better, and the craft brew industry was born, basically. So we're here today to celebrate the import beers that made American beer great again. And in doing so, I'm going to introduce three beers that I'm going to line up for the guys on the patio out over here, and we're going to see if they can detect which one is the import and which ones are the American craft brews. So let me introduce the beers. First, the import from Mexico, Bohemia, which is a German-style Pilsner. Very hoppy aroma and a nice malt base. Fantastic beer, very, very German. And why shouldn't it be German? The Germans practically invaded Mexico years and years ago. They brought their beer, they brought their music. They shouldn't have brought their music. Maybe they should have kept that at home. But they have to have something to play when they're beating up on piñatas, so it may as well be that. But the beer is fantastic. And to this day, they still influence Mexico with the styles of beer that they brew. So that's the first one, Bohemia from Mexico. The second beer the boys are gonna be tasting is Alaskan Brewing Summer Ale, which is a Kolsch style ale. Also German and very clean, very good malt background, and just a slight hop aroma that I find to be very, very pleasant, great beer. The third beer, and the one I think is gonna trip them both up, is Anchor Brewing Summer Ale, which is a wheat pale ale. And quite frankly, I think tastes more like the imports you're used to now, like Beck's and Foster's, things like that. Kind of bland, kind of corny. Wasn't exactly my favorite beer, but I think it's gonna be a great beer for this challenge. So that's it, I'm done talking. I'm gonna send you over to the next room, and we're gonna see if the guys can determine which beer is the import. Let's play Border Patrol! Now let's meet our first contestant, Hog Dawg!
It's Hog Dawg.
And our second contestant, Gonzo!
Gonzo!
Say hello to the internet, Gonzo!
Hello, internet.
Well... Okay, so here we have three beers.
Yeah.
Going from your right to your left.
From my right?
Beers...
Contestant's right?
Your contestant's right. That would be this, to this, to this. We'll call these beers A, B, and C.
A, B, and C.
Correct. Okay. In no particular order, but I'd like you to drink them in particular order.
Okay.
You can tell me by tasting, smelling, do anything you need to do, try to determine which one of these beers is the import beer and which two of these beers are American craft brews. What's your first impression of this first beer?
What,
do you have an impression of the first beer?
Floral? Unimpressed.
Yeah.
You're unimpressed?
There's nothing going on here.
Oops. Did you tasty?
Damn close in color and everything here.
Yeah, I tried to make three beers that could compete with each other.
One is an import?
One of these is an import. Two of these are American craft brews.
What country?
Can't tell you. Wow, look at the thought process going on here, folks. I told you these guys were pros.
So, can we move on to the next one?
You can go move on to B and C in no particular order. It doesn't matter how you drink these. Just have them, smell them, take a determination. Gonzo looks like he's in the witness protection program. He's not showing his face.
I don't want the public to know how I taste my beers.
That's right.
Is it top secret? Have you tasted enough to make a determination?
No, I haven't even had the third one.
All right, take
it
easy.
They're way too close.
I'll take it easy.
Yeah, they're so close
really
together.
Similar.
Wow, this contest is riveting.
Well, it's just difficult to kind of...
I think Hog Dawg has made his choice. Gonso is still sipping.
I think I know.
You had enough? Okay, let me go. First off, we're going to go to contestant number one.
I think it's C.
Hog Dawg, what's your determination?
C.
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 Gonzo, what's your determination?
A.
You like A?
C.
That was my color alone, I think it could be A. But the taste on C, I don't know.
Gonzo's picking A.
You probably picked a really shitty beer for
Import. Yeah, by color.
Heineken.
Yeah, these guys drinking. What's it gonna be, G?
I'm sticking with A.
A?
I think I am too.
What is it?
You're sticking with A?
I think I'm going with A.
You're going with A?
Yeah. Sorry. But by color, these look more like craft beers, but this looks more like a German or a Dutch importer.
It's like that floor, like you were saying. Yeah. You know, when you go back this way,
yeah,
you
then
have
it
that
tastes
one.
Different. It
tastes very different.
Yeah.
This
one here had kind of a, like there was a sulfur or something in it. But then when I drank that after this.
Got so gargled with it.
I think it's A.
Yeah.
So you both take an A?
Yeah.
Well, I have to tell you that you're both are correct. You have both picked the import. Now we need a tiebreaker. Can you tell me the beer that you've just had?
All three?
No. Can you tell me which import you tasted? You both picked A. Technically, Dawg picked C first, but then picked A. He changed his mind. He has every right to change his mind.
It wasn't official until I looked at it.
You have any idea what that is?
Gone.
It's
Dutch or something.
Dutch?
Yeah, that's my guess.
Okay, going with Dutch. Gonzo, what country do you think that's from? Okay, folks, we're running low on time, so we're going to go ahead and...
I can see a lot of editing.
I'm just going to pick Italy.
Italy? Okay, that's incorrect. The beer is from Mexico, and it is Bohemia.
Bohemia?
Which is very close, because Gonzo said that you did say Germany. So that is close, because there was a heavy German influenced beer. It tastes quite a bit like a German Pils. The second beer that you tasted, that I thought was kind of similar, that was Alaskan Summer Ale, which is a Kolsch style. Yeah. And then beer number C, which I didn't particularly care for myself, was Anchor Brewing's Summer Ale, which is a heavily wheat-based ale. Yeah. But it missed the mark entirely for me. I didn't care for it. And I hate to bang on them because they're
so
a decent brewery.
Nobody.
It was a tie.
You tied.
Round one's a tie.
Virtually sealing that this will not take off as a real game show, but at least we tried. Well, thanks everybody. Say goodbye, contestants.
Bye.
Oh, what do you win? More beer.
Yay.
Son of a bitch. I thought that was going to go a little bit better, guys. I'm so sorry. I almost tripped up Hog Dawg. I think he cheated. He was peeking off of Gonzo's cheat sheet. Well, anyway, I thought it was going to go a bit differently. I apologize, and so does the Travelocity Gnome. He apologizes too. We thought things were going to go better for us today, but as you can tell, it's a lot tougher than it sounds, and I encourage you all to try this on your friends. Take an import, and then take two American craft brews that kind of line up with that import, and see if your friends can determine which one is the import and which one's American. Everybody, let's play Border Patrol. Until next time, this has been Clark for Dude Night. We'll see you. Get some!